So pretty solid week overall. Again, we're seeing more of that growth, you know, that momentum I've been talking about over the last little bit. Really good to see all those metrics on chain, transactions, volumes, active wallets, validators, all that sort of meat and potatoes to the chain is all still trending up. That's really, really great to see. But man, I think the biggest stuff really going on is really the TradFi, man. So, you know, a couple of crazy ones, man. I would call back to the Prometheum video I did. I would love people to check that one out.
Nobody trusts these guys. It's very sketchy. But where it's such a big deal about these particular guys here at Prometheum, they have a special purpose broker-dealer's license through the SEC. The only players to have this one. Not BlackRock, not Coinbase, not Fidelity, not Kraken, not Binance. No one. No one but these guys have managed to come through and actually go through this entire process with the SEC and end up with this license.
Man, it may not seem as big a deal just yet because it's being kind of quiet, but that is going to be a big story. I'm very curious to see how that plays out with those guys and how they're custodying ETH. They are able to take retail customers. It's not even just institutions. This is going to be a big deal. I still can't believe this is as quiet as it is. So I'm really curious to see what people say on that. We did see even RH has talked about the Ethereum ETFs, which I think will be another big mover and shaker, probably bringing a lot of institutional money. The other side that is a little interesting is I've heard some of the ETH boys already bring this up. What is different is since ETH is proof of stake, just like PulseChain, an ETF, likely we'll see how they play out with staking. This is also something that's being handled in the Coinbase case. So depending on how they resolve staking, you could see just billions get locked up in the Ethereum ETFs and then be paying a staking payout. So that could be even more attractive to certain players and places than what we saw with Bitcoin, even though, again, I would still think that the Bitcoin value would still trump it. But on top of that, staking being a, you know, an interesting mechanic as far as having how those guys probably viewed as more of a dividend, that's proof of stake, man. So we could see a few very large ETF holders, JP Morgan and the such, have just an unbelievable impact on consensus there, which could, you know, bother a lot of people if you're in, you know, truly concerned about the, you know, the decentralization of these things, the, you know, the Nakamoto coefficient, a few of these big things as far as how heavy those players could be in it. That would be a big one. So I'm real interested to see how a couple of those things play out, you know, being Prometheum, and the Ethereum ETF. I think those are the big, real heavy, you know, TradFi things we have going on right now, along with a lot of the cases. But again, I don't think that stuff will be resolved for, you know, at least another couple of months. On the other side, a big one for LL. Shout out to the MCR boys and Barista. They are now live on Mainnet. They've been audited, all that kind of good stuff. And that is the first sort of third party or secondary front end to liquid loans. It's a big part of, you know, seeing our ecosystem grow, having alternate front ends. I do have a few large players on ETH who had reached out and were like, hey, you know, we're very familiar with liquidity. We want to bring more value over to the ecosystem. I got to have second front ends. You know, they got to have some redundancy. So that was really great to see. So, you know, big tip of the hat to those guys. Really excited. I do think that we're going to see more and more things come online. I know there's a few other teams that are building stuff on top of LL. People looking at adding, you know, additional features and all that kind of good stuff to loan and fetch. That's a big one. A lot of questions on that. Make sure you guys catch CC's dev update. He did a good one. He addressed some things that have been going on in the community, as well as a big update on fetch and some, you know, his timeline is no timeline, but you know, the timeline so that people have an idea what's going on there. But guys, I think that's the biggest stuff, man. We're seeing our personal ecosystem grow. All these sort of big main metrics on PulseChain are still going up and to the right. The Pulse price is, you know, holding, you know, steadily above where it was, kind of setting, you know, higher lows, which is what we want to see earlier in the bull run. And guys, it's a beautiful day. It's finally nice out here. Catch you know, a nice walk. I do want to give a shout out to Jack Frost. He's a member who I've been talking back and forth with, who, you know, kind of highlighted like the walk and talk. So I want to shout him out a little bit. But guys, appreciate y'all. Catch y'all next week. Enjoy it. Pump up all the good charts. Buy it. DCA. Cheers.